Good morning, guys. So today is Monday, June 14th, and I'm currently 12 days out from my next show. Yeah, so it's like 7:40 in the morning, and I'm getting ready to do my fasted cardio. So for today's cardio, it's gonna be 30-second sprints on the elliptical. I could pick the elliptical or the treadmill, but I have an elliptical at home, so I figured I would just do it here, make it more convenient since I have work later today. And then, 30-second sprints on the elliptical. And then I put the band on, and I'm going to do 25 plyo jump squats, and then 12 side shuffles each side. So yeah, I have like a lot of rounds of that. I'm not gonna say how many, but gonna do that, and then I'm gonna get ready to go to the gym, and then I have work later. So this week is the week before my peak week, and it's probably just gonna be like a lot of cardio, pretty intense. Probably like a rough week to get through, but I feel like I've already kind of been like doing this now for a while, so like I don't feel as bad as I did for the first show. Yeah, I feel like I'm kind of just like getting used to this. So I'm gonna do my cardio, and and that was only the second round. Okay guys, so I just finished that HIIT circuit. It took a while. I'm literally dripping in sweat. Body is super sore. Feels good to have it done. Sometimes you just like have to push through even though it gets really hard or you want to give up. You just have to think of the outcome, and you know, like, as soon as I step on stage, I forget about all these, like, hard days and all this cardio, all the times that I'm, like, so hungry or, like, so cranky and my body's sore. Like, stepping on that stage is, like, what makes it so worth it to me. And, like, that feeling that you get of just, like, feeling accomplished, feeling, like, that you did something that like not a lot of people can't do. And yeah, so that's just like what keeps me motivated, keeps me going. I just keep pushing through and know that the outcome is what's worth it. So, oh my God, literally, I don't know if you can tell, but I am dripping. Like my knees are sweaty. My whole back is sweaty. Yeah, so finished my fasted cardio, then I'm gonna get ready to go to the gym. Thank you. So today is Wednesday, June 16th, and I am currently 11 days out from my next show. So yeah, today I did wake up like my new lowest weigh-in, other than my last show. I was 119.8, and yeah, so unfortunately yesterday, I was supposed to train and I ended up just having to take a rest day because I'm not feeling too well. I kind of have like a slight cough, and yeah, so we're just trying to like shake the cough before peak week, and hopefully I'm feeling better by then. Yeah, but I mean, I really just like don't want to let this, I guess, sickness get in the way of me doing this show. So I mean, I'm still pushing through, still trying to get past it, but yeah, I mean, things like this are gonna happen. You're gonna have to go through some obstacles through prep because that's how life works. So yeah, just gotta get through it. And yeah, but I mean, I'm not mad at the way I'm looking. And yesterday it was just like the leanest I felt. I had like literally like veins coming out everywhere, so not mad about it. But yeah, so just did my check-ins with my coach, and then I'm gonna see what he says for me to do today. Okay guys, so after checking in with my coach today, we decided that it's best for me to take a rest day today. That means no cardio, no training. Yeah, and then what he ended up doing was he changed my meal plan for the day, since I don't feel too well. So yeah, I'm just, you know, picking up some of the things that was missing that he had on this meal plan. So yeah, I just pulled up at the food store, gonna pick up that, and then I'm gonna pick up some like vitamins and pills he told me to get too. So yeah, I mean, I don't like resting, obviously. Like, I want to be able to train, I want to be able to give it 100%. So the fact that, you know, I don't even feel well and that this is out of my control is just like, it sucks. But yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, like, I know me resting and everything will just be better for me. Hopefully, yeah, I mean, hopefully I get better. We just want to get me 100% by peak week. So yeah, I know it will just benefit me. And yeah, I just gotta trust what he says, trust the process. So that's what I'm gonna do. So yeah, I'm just gonna run in, grab the things that he told me to get, and I'll show you guys what I end up getting. Okay, so I'm about to have my second meal today, which is just 3.5 ounces of chicken, and then I have 100 grams of green beans here. He had me put some extra virgin olive oil on this meal, and then what I picked up at the food store was an apple. I got a pink lady apple because I think that they are the best. And then here's the medicine that I had to get. Literally never heard of these, but yeah, hopefully they're gonna help and make me feel better, and I'll feel 100% by peak week. And yeah, so I'm gonna have this, and then I'll show you guys my next meal, and then I think Alex is probably gonna come over. We're probably just gonna hang out by the pool and like literally just like rest all day, because yeah, rest is key right now. So I'll have this and I'll show you guys what I have next. Okay, here's my third meal today. I have another thing of 3.5 ounces of chicken, 100 grams of green beans, and then some avocado on the side. And I have an Alex.
I'm about to go to the gym, so I have.
Yeah, let me know. What you got, Alex? Because yours looks a lot better than mine.
Yeah, this sounds crazy. I have low sugar oats. I haven't had the red velvet in my oats in a minute. Because I've been having the peanut butter toffee. Mm. So I have...
It smells so good.
Yeah, I know. So I have the oats. I have like 500 grams of oats. I have like 3 scoops of protein in it to give it its flavor. A little
That's
dash,
why he's so big, guys.
A little dash of Alden Farms. Mm. So it gives it, you know, it makes it a little sweet.
Sweet.
And 4 tablespoons of peanut butter. Good luck.
Ah. Ooh, that looks so banging. He is so lucky. I haven't had oats in I don't even know how long. Like, I couldn't tell you the last time I ate oatmeal.
You're gonna eat
cream of rice.
Cream of rice.
Yeah. I miss me some oats. But yeah, so we're gonna eat. I'm gonna watch him eat that. And I'll see you guys for my next meal.
Hey guys, here's my 4th meal of the day. I have 3.5 ounces of flank steak and then some asparagus. So yeah, I'm gonna have this one and I'll show you guys my last 2 meals after.
Here's my 5th meal. It is literally just 3.5 ounces of chicken and then I got to pick either cashews or almonds, and I pick cashews because I prefer cashews. So yeah, I'm gonna have this and then my last meal I'm probably just gonna have at Alex's house, so I probably just won't show you, but it's just egg whites, vegetables, and one whole egg. So today it seemed like he kept the fats pretty high. I feel like that has something to do with, like, you know, me not feeling well. So, like, I guess, like, the fats probably have something to do with my immune system. So, yeah, really high fat day, and no carbs. And, yeah, I'm already starting to feel better. And hopefully I'll get back to training tomorrow. And, yeah, hopefully I'm just not sick anymore. And maybe I'll show you guys my workout either tomorrow or on Friday. So yeah, and then peak week is coming up soon, so I will do another peak week vlog and then another show day vlog. So yeah, exciting stuff coming up, and that is pretty much it. So I'll catch you guys next time. I'm in it.